Pity poor Albert Einstein, the brightest young mind around. His head-breaking notion of Brownian motion is widely considered profound. He showed why we wanta define light as quanta. I have to admit that was smart, but like me and like you, he hasn't a clue when it comes to affairs of the heart. Regrettably, love is not a science. It practically bursts with sheer defiance. The head and the heart are a misalliance. Somebody should sue for non-compliance. Love is not schematic. Its shape and its form are too erratic. Though nature wants us to pause for love, she didn't provide any laws for love, and as a result, it's problematic. Thank you, my good friend Vesto, for putting me in my place.
You're welcome.
You've proved that my mind is the limited kind, and you've made quite an eloquent case. Your views are extensive and so comprehensive. Your point is undoubtedly true. Successful advancing in love and romancing requires a moron like you to come. Regrettably, love allows no measure. It weakens your mind and spoils your leisure. Though many have found it a thing to treasure, I find that it only creates displeasure. Love is but ephemeral. There's clearly no reliance. Though some could resent of love, if I could only be rid of love, I'd jump for joy and stick to science.
In matters of love, you're always defenseless. There's nothing to keep love from attacking and beating you senseless. It's easy to find somebody you'd like to live in sin with, but then love disappears as fast as it came to begin. Is not astronomy.
Has no design and lacks economy.
You can't attend any school for love, which means you're always a fool for love, and we'd rather retain complete autonomy. Love is not empirical.
It isn't convex, oblong,
or spherical. It's usually soft and vague and lyrical.
Yeah, emerging alive requires a miracle.
Dependence and makes you abandon self-reliance. Though some of the blood and the joys,
we just want to be free of the noise
so we can